High performance culture is a culture that basically can achieve the results that it is intended to achieve. They achieve the impact that they were designed to achieve. And a high performance organization, its results are captured basically in its mission and vision statement. And so a high performance organization is one that will achieve its mission, fulfill it, and also achieve its vision. Now, lots of organizations, lots of leaders can prove that they do lots of activity. They can prove that they get things done. They can prove that they hire people. They can prove that they complete projects, that they create products and services. But what we don't get enough of is proof of impact. That how well did we fulfill our mission? How well did we achieve our vision? Or how close did we get to it? High-performance cultures focus on results, but they also focus on the approach that they use to achieve those results. It's probably true to say that sport and business have been compared a lot and probably a little bit too much, but when you think about Billy Beane, who was the general manager of the Oakland A's baseball team, and we know of Billy Beane from Brad Pitt's portrayal of him in the movie Moneyball. Billy Beane basically revolutionized the way baseball is run as a business. And he revolutionized it because he believed very much in the impact, not just the activity, not just about hiring the best players and how much you spend on them and how good their hitting rates are. Billy Beane wanted to understand what the drivers were of the true purpose of a baseball team, which is to win and to climb through the ranks. Now, the Oakland A's started at the bottom of the league, basically. And Billy Beane worked with his analyst, who was Paul DePodesta. They used data in a very, very different way to how baseball had used data before and ended up on a very, very, very slim budget, climbing through the leagues and achieved very, very great results based on data, not based on having millions and millions of dollars to play the best players. So a high-performance organization does very, very well at the game that it's playing, and for business, the game is achieving its mission. A lot of leaders will think, well, does that mean that evidence of high performance is profit? If we've got great profit, doesn't that mean we're a great organization? And that's quite a common thing to default to. However, think about a chicken farm. One of the things that a chicken farm will do is maximize the number of chickens per square foot of space so they can get the most eggs or the most chicken production and the most profit. But there are consequences to that, and the consequences are felt by the people who live in the vicinity of the farm. The consequences are observed in nature, where all the runoff from the farming can kill aquatic life in nearby streams. So if we think just about profit, we're not thinking systemically. We're not thinking in a balanced enough way. So we can't really define the chicken farm as a high-performing organization. We need to think about all the stakeholders that are impacted by the organization and define high performance in that kind of way.